Everybody, this is a RockShox lyric, U-turn, 160, 115. You can adjust the travel from this knob here, rotating to the left or to the right, according to the plus or minus indicator. Motion control. High speed, low speed compression, floodgate, of course, for low speed, and rebound here. Today I'm gonna try something I observed and I wanted to do for a long time. I have this fork for at least 4 years. It is a great fork. I love it. The setup is great for a dirt jumper, specifically for this dirt jumper. Polarix is a dream build, but to be honest with you, the coil was a little bit soft for my all-around preference and style of riding. Not because I couldn't do something or I failed in some way, but I was bottoming out. Not often, but with ease, or with not that aggressive jumps. So, as a solution, or as a hack, I come with this idea. Firstly, remove this cap, which has these components. All right. Make sure you don't lose them, so you can use a magnet. This is a safety feature to remove the next part, and this is the mechanical ensemble that clicks. After you remove that safety thing, you can remove this black cap. Of course, here is a seal, but we ignore that for a moment. So, because this part is completely flat, as you can see, nothing special, just a cap over a machined aluminum part here, which I tried easily to remove with a screwdriver, but it is a little stuck there, and I don't want to, and I don't need to remove it. I came up with the next idea. So, by the design, as you can see, this part here, the top part, which is also the knob you rotate to adjust the height, is a little bit off this limit, and of course, if I want to soften the spring, I'll have to give up to this adjustment, which in personal experience I can tell that not even few times I touched to lower the travel to 115. I touched it because, as I will show you on my laptop, this tend to go to the minimum position by itself. So this is the minimum. By rotating clockwise or anti-clockwise, this spring goes up or down, and in this way the travel goes up and down. And now with this upgrade, with the travel maxed up, I will soften the spring rate. So how this work, it's a really simple system. As you can see here in this exploded view, this rod in the left arm, this left arm have a rod connected from the bottom, so you can't extract here this coil if you don't unscrew the bolt, and of course you lose lower leg fluid. But we don't even need for this operation, because now I see there are three coils. No problem, because I have here exactly two more. Yeah. But how this works? By you rotating the coil on this fixed part, here is a thread, plastic piece, threaded, and by you rotating the coil, it goes up or down. Exactly like Coca-Cola or any bottle with a cap. A very simple system. So, the solution I found was a very simple one. Of course, I gave up at that setting by height, and I will put some washers which are perfectly, as you can see here, alright, so almost perfect sized. I'm very lucky to found them here, so I don't go to shop. So easy. Of course, the center, as you can see, or not. As you can see, is bigger on the washer than on the original part, so there would not be any problem touching inside. But of course we ask the question, will it work or will it wiggle? Because it wiggles now if we raise this for half a centimeter or even an eighth of centimeter. It will wiggle more and more. But I thought to add an extra seal, and it will stop the wiggle. As you will see, it will fit as I plan. So a little bit up, of course I wouldn't be able to adjust it anymore, no problem. I will fix it on the maximum position from now. Hopefully it will not thread down, and with this screw here I found the next solution. As you can see, this is the original screw. Alright, very nice, conical, but not a problem if I will do in a different way. I found this screw, but it won't work because the thread is a little bit bigger than this one and this one. This one will fit. If I put this like this, or like this, you can see the thread is a little bit thinner on this. So, for this cap to still be there, not functionally but aesthetically and defensively, I will use it with a small washer and we will see if it works. I've came with a better solution. I told I will use here just one single seal, but I inserted almost 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 O-rings. All right, for the height, which is almost perfect, so this will not wiggle. Now we'll install everything, grease them a little bit so they will last longer and will be inserted much easier. Next part is installing the O-ring, the seal of this original cap. So inserting it here, little grease, this was a little more but it's completely fine. Another one extra and it will be ready to go. Oh sheesh. Hard to film and work at the same time. But of course I'm an elite and I can do this even with closed eyes. As that, and now is the well-waited moment to test if it works. Hopefully I will manage this by myself, but if I can do, I'll ask for someone so I can press this cap and also twist and thread it back or screw it back. Yeah, screw it. So as you can see, now you can't actuate this travel control here, but it's not a problem. The travel is at 160. Hopefully the sag indicator will be lower. I forgot to measure it before, but I will feel the difference. Of course I am well knowing this fork, and maybe I will come with the last part testing this good boy. as you can see, much better. And even if I'm not a great jumper, I don't lie, but I think I can use this fork for even higher jumps, but not now. Updating the situation, everything worked really well, but because the travel decreased after I came home from the test I executed, I had to remove the coil. This is the system I was talking about. Now it is blocked. You will see why. The principle is simple. This green gray coil is rotating, and this silver part and this white plastic are fixed in this bolt in the lower leg. So when you twist the coil, it is going down and the white part is going up. So now I fixed it. I can say I fixed it because I don't use 150 millimeters ever. But if I will want to, and of course coming back to the original form with no washers, so a softer coil, I could always readjust the travel. So this is the final form I gave to this part, because the Achilles weak point was exactly this point here. So in order to stop this coil to go down, I thought really well, and the only solution was to make a hole, as you can see, and insert a screw, a nail, whatever, doesn't matter. As you can see, I did the hole through the entire stick, and it is filled, so it's not hollow. Here is only a thread, so I can confirm that you won't have any problems with drilling a hole in this stick, aluminum stick. So now, as you can see, this screw will block the coil, which is perfectly. I will install and use this system. So this is the last part where I'll compare the sag with how I remember it to be. On the last part of the travel, even if the spring rate is very linear, the progressivity on the last part is exactly how it should be. So no more lowering the travel, and also the right amount of spring rate for my weight.
which is a little bit higher, 3 kilograms higher than usual, but worth mentioning. So yeah, now the SAG test. Alright, find a place like this, hand on the handlebars, put your feet, and as you can see, it is half. You can see, but you can see is very, very little. And I know that before it was almost double. So yeah, have fun. And the result is satisfying, almost bottom, but it feels so good.
Oh yes, yes.